What is this box?
It's the mystery box.
Not just the mystery box, it's the the magical mystery box. And magical and mystery are what type of words?
Adjectives.
Adjectives are?
Describing a noun.
Describing a noun. Okay, so it's magical and it's mysterious. We're going to use an advanced organizer to get our thoughts going and to launch us into our process of our activity today. Okay? So, we're going to play the game 10 questions. It does need sunlight. I'm going to do a tail off right here. Sunlight. Because sunlight helps it.
It's hard.
Right.
Is it hard as a rock?
It can be hard as a rock. It's somewhere. Or solid. Look, I'm going to tail off of solid. Hard as a rock. What is that? As a symbol. A rock. It is solid. It can be hard as a rock. Hard as a rock is a?
It
you build stuff with it. It keeps something cool. And in the context, we've talked about that quite a bit. It can be considered a legend, part of history, right? Made by hand. The item in the magical mystery box. One, two, three.
Adobe bricks!
These are actually, we have Adobe bricks. So this is what our goal is today. And we will investigate these more during universal access or in a station later, because we're going to talk about the details and characteristics of it. We're going to state our objective now. We're going to show the sequence of events of making Adobe bricks. Okay? And how we're going to do that is we're going to, at some point, we're going to communicate with the peer the sequence of events using complete sentences and using vocabulary we've learned along the way. Going in our thinking process here, I want you to think of a question about Adobe, and you're going to communicate that question to a peer. The peer is then going to communicate an answer using complete sentences and your PK, your knowledge of Adobe. Here we go. We're going to use the language frames here. Flash, flash.
Yes, yes.
Teach.
Okay.
Norris?
Knockouts!
Okay, here we go. Now, what we're going to do is, everyone look up on the screen, we're going to come back to our, what is this called? Sometimes we make cookies with it. What would we call this?
Recipe.
So, up at the top here, we put a group of things after we titled it. What would we call this group of items?
Ingredients.
Ingredients, yes. We're going to use four. One
heart, haze, and grass.
And we're going to use some
water.
Okay. Now, when we're talking about parts, we talked about in math how if there's four parts of something, there is one part compared to the four parts, one out of four. Okay? Now, we talked about ratios. Okay, can somebody in some other words explain what sequence of events means? What we do to make Adobe brick. Narrative writing, right? We say the sequence of what's gonna happen in the story, right? That is the sequence of the events, the things that happen in the story, okay? Well, that also happens when you watch TV and watch a television show. You know, the story has a sequence of events. Usually something, everything's great, then there's a what usually happens? A problem, and then usually by the end of the 30 minutes, a solution happens, right? So the sequence of events goes through that. Number one in the sequence of events is?
Pitcher and rats into blue bucket.
Okay, what color is the bucket?
Blue.
What are we placing in the bucket?
Dirt and rats.
Good. Number two.
Add water slowly, stirring constantly.
How often do we stir?
Constantly.
What did we add?
Water.
slowly is a
adjective.
I don't think so.
Verb,
which is a
action verb.
Verb is a what?
Action verb.
Okay. Number three, we
stir until mixture is like dough.
What is it supposed to be like?
Dough.
What type of dough do you picture in your head when you think of dough?
Oh, Play-Doh.
Play-Doh? What other type of dough? Pizza dough. What type of dough?
Cookie.
Well, it's, yeah, sort of. That's good.
Cookie dough.
Cookie dough. I think it's chocolate chip cookies. Okay, but anyways. Number four. My writing isn't really excellent, but let's see if we can do it.
Pack mud into Adobe mold.
What is our Adobe mold? We are using a
cooling tray.
And what are we going to do with that mud? We're going to
pack
it in. We're going to level it off at the top. Okay, then finally, the last is
let dry until fully cooked in sun.
Now we're going to go outside and make our Adobe bricks.
Yay!
So, now we have more equipment we need. We're at the outside portion. Okay, here we go. So we have our blue bucket. What did we place in our blue bucket?
Dirt!
We have dirt in our blue bucket. I chose dirt that was over here that's almost always wet. And I think it already has like almost like a sticky consistency. Okay, so we have dirt and we have about, I would say about 4 gallons, 4 buckets full of dirt. 4 parts dirt. How much hay or grass are we supposed to have?
1 part.
1 part, ratio of 4 to 1, right? Here's our grass we picked yesterday. We're going to put that in. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to mix this up. We're going to put enough water so that it becomes what type of consistency?
Like dough.
Now I'm going to mix it up. I'm probably going to need more water, which is good. I don't want to need more dirt at this point. We mix it. That was part of the sequence of events. Yeah, but yeah, the hay, that's a good question. We talked about it. The hay or the grass helps keep it together. Similar to having a bush on a hill, and it helps with erosion. You know how we talked about that? Yeah, like it, the roots or the grass helps bind it together and hold it. Now it's time for you to get dirty. You're gonna grab a big ball like this. You're gonna shape it into a nice long oval sphere. You're gonna take your thing. Now watch. Take it like this. It's gotta be thin enough to go down into it. Okay, you're gonna press, go like that. Now you wanna keep the rectangular, three-dimensional rectangular mold the shape of a rectangle, right? So you're gonna start carefully pushing it in, and then I'm gonna kinda go like this and get my rectangular shape back. Then at the top, you can even go like this helps too, to go like this. Packs it down. You get your rectangular shape, because it'll start to kind of get, it'll start rounding. Then you're gonna press this right here inward and make it nice and flat. This will now sit for at least 3 or 4 days. We'll check it out. We'll kind of test different ones and see how they are. At one point we may tear off the paper so it dries quicker. But basically that's gonna be it.